In the last video, we looked at how we can sort our responses from our Google form into separate sheets. So we can see here, this is the form responses. These are all the responses that came in from the form. And what we've done, we've used a query to sort them here. And this is the query that we've got. So we've sorted our program in lesson 5 answers into a separate sheet. Now what we're going to do is use an add-on that will answer these questions for us. To do that, we have to create a separate sheet and then import the data from this sheet. So in effect, you would have a separate sheet now for your spreadsheet lesson, for your database lesson, etc., etc. So I've created a spreadsheet here. So firstly, we need to use a formula. And the formula that we use is called import range, and then bracket. And then it's asking for a spreadsheet key. We must add the spreadsheet key in quotes. So let's put a quote in. We now have to go and get the spreadsheet key. This can be found in the URL of the spreadsheet. Now the key is this long string between the backslashes on the URL. That is a unique key that Google gives every single document within Google. And this is the unique key for this spreadsheet. So we need to copy that and then go back to our other spreadsheet and then put and then paste it in there. Then we end with a quote and then we do a comma. And then it's asking me for the range. Now the range we want is the sheet from that spreadsheet. And it's the programming sheet and it's A to F. So what we need to do is we type programming and then A to F. And this needs to be in quotes as well. And then we can close that off and then that will then bring the data from that spreadsheet. If you try to delete anything in here, it won't allow you because it's importing information from another sheet. So now add-ons. So let's add an add-on to this particular sheet. We're going to get an add-on. We're going to get the FluBaru add-on. So let's type in FluBaru. Search for that. There's the FluBaru. We can click on free. It will ask us for permission. We allow. And now you can see the FluBaru add-on has actually been installed onto our spreadsheet. So let's close this message down and go to add-ons, go to FluBaru, and grade assignment. So what it's asking for us here is what are the questions? So we know the first one is not a question. So what we need to do is skip this for grading because that's not a question. And the second one, the username, does identify the students, then normal grading. And then what we can do, we can give it a score point. Let's just give it 1. Continue. Now FluBaru is asking for an answer key. So you must have at least 1 question in there that has the correct answers. In the case of this, it was the first question that I made sure that were all the correct answers. So select the first question, but it may be a different question in your case. So in other words, you need to take the test as a teacher to get all the answers correctly so you have an answer key. Continue. So once FluBaru has graded, it will give you this spreadsheet here. It will create a new sheet within your spreadsheet called grades. And these are your grades here. Obviously, the more students that have answered those questions, you'll get more users here. To go back to FluBaru, if you wanted to run it again, you could regrade the assignment. We can email the grades out to all the students. We can view a report. And there's some advanced features here as well that you can have a look at. In the next lesson, we're going to look at how we can use another script to automatically send an email out every time a form is submitted.